Hey everyone, thanks for tuning in to Gospel Music USA. My name's Danny Jones. I'm with Singing News Magazine.
I'm Karen Peck Gooch with Karen Peck and New River.
And I'm Mike Lefevre with the Lefevre Quartet. We're so glad you joined us today because we have some great gospel music for you as usual.
That is right. We have a very talented group with us today. But before we get to that, Mike, Karen was sharing with me that she has an incredible wealth of knowledge, and today we're going to test this bit of trivia upon you.
I've been anxious to do this.
Here we go.
How many times does a hummingbird flap its wings within a minute?
A second.
A second. Let's do a second.
Yeah. How many times they flap their wings in a second?
Uh-huh. Yes.
Oh, probably about 30.
30. Well, yeah, the answer to that question, you are completely 100% wrong. The answer is 200 times per second.
Wow.
Now, that has absolutely nothing to do with gospel music or our guest today, but we thought you needed to know that.
Hey, they'll be flapping double time when they hear this next group.
Yes, they will.
There you go.
If you like gospel music in that style that you just open up and let it fly, I promise you, you will enjoy this family right here. They come to us from Nashville, Tennessee. Would you make welcome Goodman Revival?
That'll be a happy morning over the sea. When the cares of life shall pass away,
shall pass away forever.
You'll be there to welcome all the ransomed and free.
When they ring the bells of heaven on that day,
oh, when they ring the bells of heaven, ring the bells of glory, when redeemed are gathered on that day,
on a hallelujah morning,
everybody's singing,
shouting,
what a happy meeting.
When they
ring the bells of heaven on that day,
oh, happy.
Rejoicing through this unfriendly land, for we land is waiting all the way.
The sun is always shining.
That'll be the battle coming, won't it be grand?
When they ring the bells of heaven on that day,
oh, when they ring the bells of heaven,
heaven,
ring the bells of glory, when redeemed are gathered on that day,
hallelujah,
everybody singing,
shouting,
what a happy. Morning, everybody's singing,
shouting, what a happy meeting.
When they
ring the bells of heaven on that day.
When they ring the bells of heaven on that day.
Oh, that's a mouthful of words.
And it's quick, too.
Tanya, your dad wrote some wonderful, wonderful songs. I was thinking the other day about how many gospel sermons I've heard about the love of God and our relationship with God as His children. I've heard a lot of sermons about the love of God and how it reaches to everyone. But I've never heard a preacher stand behind the pulpit and preach a sermon and explain to me fully why God loves us the way He does. I think the closest I've ever come to hearing that explanation is from a song that your dad wrote many years ago. And it says, "Who am I that a king would bleed and die for?"
When I think of how He came so far from glory, He came and dwelt among the lowly, such as I, and He suffered shame and such disgrace on Mount Calvary. Ask myself this question. go, for who am I? Then I'm reminded of his words, I'll leave you never. If you'll be true,
welcome back to Gospel Music USA. Our guest today, Goodman Revival. And as we mentioned on a previous show, there is a lot of gospel music experience sitting over there today. Now, let's run down the line. Now, most folks know Tanya, of course, the daughter of the late Rusty Goodman, traveled with the Goodmans for many years. And then Johnny Minnick down here on the other end played the piano for the Happy
this
Goodman family for several years. And then there's that one in the middle.
Yeah, but that...
And that one in the middle has had his hand in a lot of influential things in the world of gospel music.
I tell you, he has. Yeah. But here's something that I'm curious about, is at what point did you look at him and say, he is the one for me?
Be nice.
You know what? We knew each other 3 months.
That's about
3
right.
months before we got married.
Three.
Now,
wow.
I don't recommend that.
Don't try this at home.
That doesn't always work. I know other people have done that. It hadn't worked out so well. But really, and you know, you want to hear like the hokiest, okay. I mean, this is a marriage made in Southern Gospel Heaven. Guess where we met?
Southern Gospel.
NQC.
Oh, NQC.
I mean, NQC.
Oh, I love that.
We'll go back to that. What were you doing at NQC that year?
Rusty had called me 6 months earlier, and I was in another group. I couldn't come at the time to play piano.
Okay.
And I had just turned my life over to the Lord. And James Gordon Freese
was playing bass for us.
Said, you need to call him. He's at a good place.
Yeah.
And Rusty hired me. He hired me before I ever met her.
Right.
Well, was he thrilled when you two were together, got married?
Well, ultimately he was, but you have to tell him the story. At the time, we were kind of dating on the quiet.
Oh, okay.
Because you're not supposed to date guys in the group. Because what if it doesn't work out?
Yeah.
Then you have to be on the bus together and
awkward.
One another. Awkward. Yeah. So, you know, there was kind of I wasn't supposed to date, you know, the band. So we were kind of... dating on the sly. And my dad was doing some solo concerts at the time, and Michael was going out and playing piano for him.
We were on an airplane, and Rusty was just about to nod off. I said, hey, man, I got something to ask you. What's the policy? I mean, really, what is the policy on guys in the band dating the boss's daughter? And he said, I kill them.
No. Oh, that's funny.
But he was our biggest advocate when it all came down. He was our best friend.
Yeah, he was Michael's best friend.
Well, sometimes parents just know as well. Yeah. I mean, they really do.
Was it love at first sight, or did it take a little while?
We only dated 3 months, so it was
either way, it wasn't long.
I was pretty convinced.
You were pretty.
I remember what she wore. I remember the dress. It was a Norma Kamali. Is that right?
Wow.
Michael,
I'm impressed.
That is. That's points awesome. On the anniversary.
Big old shoulder pads. I remember those.
And
those shoulder pads.
I can remember when y'all got married, because I was with the Nealands. We worked with y'all a lot. Mm-hmm. And you and Kelly grew up together.
Yeah,
you know, best buddies. And one thing I will say about you, Tanya, though, is your voice. When you sing, it's like you have a voice like nobody. You know, it's like it's so anointed, and it's just so smooth, and it's beautiful.
You're just so sweet.
I had to say
that's
that.
That's the way I feel about you.
You're so
you make me cry.
You made me cry.
That's an honor coming from you. Absolutely. That really is. Thank you.
Well, thank you.
It's very sweet.
You know, y'all are just incredible. Every one of you just stand on your own. And Michael produced Karen Peckany River for several years, you know, because of you, I was able to just let loose a little more with the fast tunes and, you know, and have fun with it. And that's what, you know, and then you also produced the Gaither Vocal Band, the Oak Ridge Boys, the Martins. My goodness, the list goes on and on and on. And so, and then you're able now to set back, and now you're doing this new thing, Goodman Revival.
We're having a blast.
And Johnny over there, Johnny, you pastored a church for years.
What happened before the Goodmans? Where were you at all those years? I mean,
high school.
So right out of high school.
Right out of high school. Yeah.
Right out of high school.
So the Goodmans hired me right after I graduated from high school.
So really, you've been a Goodman from.
For a long time, I've ate a lot of their groceries. I sure have.
Now, I'll tell you, he's all bragging himself, but Johnny was quite the celebrity on that whole teen talent circuit. I mean, he was renowned for his great piano playing.
And he is amazing.
And he was,
he is.
You know, in the Assemblies of God, very, very well respected, and even just as a young man, you know.
And you know, a good name will carry you a long, long way. And Johnny Manick and all of you have great names. And that's part of what makes Goodman Revival work is the legacy that you all have in gospel music, plus the way you've protected that legacy. And that's so important.
And
people don't realize how quickly your name can be tarnished if you're not paying attention.
And it looks like fun.
It does.
we have a good time.
We're getting away with something.
See, you're bringing us, though, on that stage with y'all. You know, you're bringing us to the party, if I can say. You know, it's like, but then when you get to start, when you start singing Who Am I or Look For Me, it's like, okay, here come the tears. So, but it's what a great, just a great thing you have going. And then Johnny, just right quick, share with us just something, your experience with the Lord that, you know, what over the years have you really learned the most?
Well, to keep it in the vein of what you just said, I've learned that I'm such a sinner and He's such a Savior. My best, according to what I've read in Scripture, is filthy rags. On my best day, I'm terrible. But He is such a Savior that it overcomes any barrier or obstacles or problems or iniquity or sin or whatever, as long as I walk in the light. Now, that's the effort part. And that's what I try my best to do, is stay in the light, because He said, if you walk in the light as He is in the light, then you have fellowship one with the other, and the blood of Jesus Christ cleanses you from all unrighteousness.
Amen.
So the older I get, the more I try to just stay in the light.
But you're not getting old.
Right, just getting better.
That's right.
Thank you. I do want to say this about Michael, too. I had the opportunity several years ago. He produced, when I was with Brian Free,
yeah,
produced our first albums. I can still say album, right?
Yeah.
And every time, even though we haven't worked, he is such a, he's got the gift of encouragement. Mm-hmm. We sang with y'all the other night, and man, when we come off the stage, he made us feel like we had just were somebody, and all of you did. But I love that. You know, that's a good thing for. That's what we need to be. We need to be encouragers.
Yeah.
And so many times we overlook people that may not be sitting on this sofa, but people need encouragement.
One thing with Michael makes you better.
Yeah.
You have a gift of pulling out whatever talent we may have and make it better.
Thanks, Karen.
And so that's a gift. Yeah. It really is.
You ought to keep him.
I need to come. I know one thing. I need to come down here more.
Wow. Okay. Well, we've got about a minute left here. Let's ask the obvious question. Is Michael at home the way he is on the stage? Is he wide open?
He is. He is very hyper. He is hyper. He
help me, John.
He doesn't like to. He doesn't like to wait in lines, and he'll tell you like if it doesn't matter. Like if I don't know, the finest chef in the universe is preparing the meal at this restaurant, like he is not going to sit there and wait 45 minutes.
My kind.
He's like, ain't no meal. Ain't no
right
meal
there.
On earth. Yeah.
But I can say
no
this.
No soup worth it.
Yeah, but you listen, that new grandbaby you have.
Oh.
Now,
oh,
I know
mercy.
That's turned your world upside
She's
down.
She's only everything.
Oh, yeah.
Is that all?
That's good.
All right, folks, we're going to come back. Let Goodman Revival do a few more songs for us. Don't go anywhere. Gospel music is right here on Gospel Music USA.
We've had a great day here on Gospel Music USA, and we're so glad you have joined us. Our guests today have just been incredible, and we're about to hear them sing right now. Listen to Goodman Revival.
I'll be there. What will it be when we get over yonder to join the throng upon the glassy sea? We'll greet our loved ones and crown Christ forever. This is just what heaven needs to be. We'll greet our loved ones and crown Christ forever. This is just what heaven means to me. This is just what heaven means to me.
Wow. What a song. Oh, my goodness. Y'all, thank y'all so much for being with us this week on the show. And I will say this. I know all of you at home are saying the same thing, but out of all the shows that I think I've done, this is one of my very favorite shows.
Thank you.
I don't know why every time I see y'all, I want to cry. because y'all are longtime friends, and when I see y'all, I love y'all. Oh, my gosh.
We love you, too.
And y'all, thank you so much for joining us this week on Gospel Music USA. And, hey, right quickly, tell the folks at home how to get in touch with Goodman Revival.
GoodmanRevival.com.
Yes, and
pretty
listen,
simple. GoodmanRevival.com.
GoodmanRevival.com, and also I follow you on Instagram, so they're on Instagram.
I'm on Instagram. Yes. Goodman Revival's on Instagram. We're on Facebook, Goodman Revival on Facebook, so y'all come join us.
Yes, and y'all log on and get their music. It will bless you beyond measure. Maybe you know someone that needs to hear, "This is just what heaven means to me." Oh, and so many other great songs. Thank y'all again for joining us this week, and God bless y'all. I love y'all so much, and you're going to sing another song.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll see y'all next time.
Journey now, gotta make it to heaven somehow. Though the devil bit me and he's trying to turn me around, he's offered everything that's got a name. All the wealth I want, world and fame. If I could, still I wouldn't take nothing for my journey now.
And I've traveled for the Lord many years ago. I've had a lot of heartache and I've met a lot of grief and woe. But when I would stumble, then I would humble down. And there I'd say, I wouldn't take nothing for my journey now.
Well, I wouldn't take nothing for my journey now. Gotta make it to heaven somehow. Though the devil took me and he tried to turn me around. He's offered everything that's got a name, all the wealth I want. World and fame, if I could, still I wouldn't take nothing for my journey now. Oh, there ain't nothing in the world that will ever take the place of God's love.
Oh, the silver and gold can never buy money touch from above. When my soul needs healing, I begin to feeling His power. And it's there I'd say, I wouldn't take nothing for my journey now.
Wouldn't take nothing for my journey now. Gotta make it to heaven somehow. Though the devil took me and he tried to turn me around. He's offered everything that's got a name. All the wealth I want, worldly fame, if I could, still I wouldn't take nothing for my journey now.
No, no, no.
I wouldn't take nothing for my journey now. Gotta make it to heaven somehow. Though the devil took me and he tried to turn me around.
You know
he's offered everything that's got a name. All the wealth I want, worldly fame, if I could, still I wouldn't take nothing for my journey now.
If I could still, I wouldn't take nothing for my journey.